This video lecture is for BSc third semester physics of Mysore University. Dear students, in this session I will discuss about the expression for power in AC circuits, calculation of power factor, discussion of power factor in special cases, derivation of expression for current in parallel LCR circuit, and also expression for impedance and resonant frequency in parallel LCR circuit. Let us recap what we have learned in the previous session. Those are the construction of an AC circuit consisting inductance, capacitance and resistance, significance of the resonant frequency in a series LCR circuit, half power frequencies and bandwidth, Q factor of series LCR circuit and its physical meaning. Following are the prerequisites for this session. Knowledge about response of parallel AC circuit with inductance, capacitance and resistance. Knowledge about impedance, resonant frequency in an LCR series circuit. Knowledge about bandwidth and Q factor in series LCR circuit. And knowledge about power in a circuit, etc. Now, let us discuss the expression for power in AC circuits and calculation of power factor. As you know, power in a DC circuit is the product of voltage and current. In the same way, we can define power in an AC circuit also. The power in an AC circuit is equal to the product of the instantaneous EMF and instantaneous current, which is averaged over a complete cycle. If an alternating voltage V is applied to the AC circuit, we get the instantaneous current I. The applied instantaneous EMF is given by V is equal to V naught into sin omega t, and the corresponding current what we get is I is equal to I naught into sin omega t minus pi. To calculate the power, we have to multiply voltage and the current. We get the expression P is equal to V into I, that is equal to V naught sin omega t into I naught sin omega t minus pi, that is equal to V naught into I naught into sin omega t into sin omega t minus pi. So here we can use a trigonometric function, that is sin A into cos B, which is equal to cos A minus B minus cos A plus B divided by 2. If we apply this function in this expression, we get P, power P is equal to V naught into I naught into cos omega t minus omega t plus phi minus cos omega t plus omega t minus phi divided by 2. We will get this expression as V naught into I naught by 2 into cos phi minus cos 2 omega t minus phi. We have to get the average of this power. The average power over a complete cycle of AC can be given by P average is equal to the integration within the limits 0 to t of V naught I naught by 2 into cos phi minus cos 2 omega t minus phi divided by integration of time within the limit 0 to t. On simplification of this expression, we arrive at a final expression as P average, that is the average power over a complete cycle, is equal to V naught by root 2 into I naught by root 2 into cos phi. So where the term cos phi is called the power factor of the circuit. Thus the power is determined by a power factor in addition to the voltage and current in an AC circuit. Now we can write the expression as true power is equal to apparent power into power factor. Hence the power factor, which is the term cos phi, is the ratio of the true power to the apparent power. A true power or real power, which is also known as active power, performs the real work within the electrical circuit. Real power measured in watts defines the power consumed by the resistive part of the circuit. Then power in an AC circuit is the same power in a DC circuit. Apparent power will also be there in a AC circuit, which comes from the reactive power in the circuit. This apparent power is also known as demand and is a measure of the amount of power used and run the equipment. For a series LCR circuit, expression for the power factor we get is cos phi is equal to R divided by square root of R square plus omega L minus 1 by omega C whole square. Now we shall discuss the power factor in special cases. The power factor is decided by the phase angle phi, that is the phase difference between the applied voltage and the corresponding current in the circuit. Now, the case number 1, in a purely resistive circuit, the voltage is in phase with the current, so the phase angle phi is equal to 0, then the term cos phi will be equal to cos 0, that is equal to 1, then we get the true power is equal to V naught into I naught. That means the true power is equal to apparent power in the circuit. Secondly, in a pure inductive circuit, there will be a phase difference of phi is equal to 90 degree in the circuit. Then we get cos 90 degree is equal to 0, hence the true power is equal to 0. Next, in a purely capacitive circuit also, there will be a phase difference of minus 90 degree between current and voltage. Cos minus 90 degree will be is equal to 0, hence the true power in this case is also 0. Thus no power is consumed in the circuit even though there is a current. Such a current flowing in a circuit for which the power consumed is zero is called wattless current. Next, in the fourth case, in an AC circuit containing a resistance and inductance in series, the power factor cos phi is equal to R divided by square root of R square plus omega L whole square. In an AC circuit containing a resistance and capacitive in series, the power factor will be is equal to R divided by R square plus 1 by omega C whole square. These are the different cases in case of power factor. Now we shall discuss a parallel LCR circuit and we shall derive an expression for the current in a parallel LCR circuit. In the figure you can see a parallel LCR circuit where in one arm the inductor and the resistor are there. In the other arm parallel to this there is a capacitor connected in the circuit. An alternating voltage V is equal to V naught into e to the power j omega t is applied to the circuit. Now we can find out the expression for the current. Here the parallel circuit with resistance in the inductance arm, the current in the inductance arm is IL is equal to V naught divided by square root of R square plus omega L whole square. The current in the capacitance arm IC is equal to V naught divided by 1 by omega C. Here the current IC leads the potential by pi by 2 and it is represented in the diagram. So you can see in a phasor diagram the representation of current IC, the current IL, etc. The current IC is represented by OB along OY. Hence the current along OY dash is IL sin phi is equal to IL into omega L divided by R square plus omega L whole square, which is within the square root. If we substitute for IL, we get this is equal to V naught into omega L divided by R square plus omega L whole square. We can get the current along OY is equal to V naught divided by 1 by omega C, that is equal to V naught omega C. Hence the net current along OY will be equal to V naught omega C minus V naught omega L divided by R square plus omega L whole square. Now we shall look into the expression for impedance and resonant frequency in a parallel LCR circuit. When the inductive reactance is equal to the capacitive reactance, we get the resonance condition. So here in case of parallel resonance, the condition is different. That means it is unlike the series resonance. So here at resonance impedance is maximum and the current will be minimum at resonance. The condition of resonance can be given by C into R square plus omega L whole square is equal to L. At resonance impedance is equal to EMF by current, that is equal to V naught divided by IL cos phi, where IL is equal to V naught R divided by R square plus omega L whole square. Substituting for omega from the condition of resonance IL and cos phi, we get the impedance as impedance is equal to L by CR. Now we can also get the expression for the resonant frequency by substituting the value of omega is equal to 2 pi fr in the above equation, that is the equation for the condition of resonance, that is C into R square plus omega L whole square is equal to L. We simplify the equation and we will arrive at the resonant frequency equation F is equal to 1 by 2 pi into root LC into square root of L minus CR square divided by L, or this expression can be rewritten as F is equal to 1 by 2 pi into square root of 1 by LC minus R square by L square. This is the expression for the resonant frequency. Hence, a parallel resonant circuit is known as a rejector circuit. We know that a series resonant circuit is known as acceptor circuit. Here a parallel resonant circuit is known as a rejector circuit, because at resonance the impedance of the circuit is at its maximum, thereby suppressing or rejecting the current whose frequency is equal to its resonant frequency. At parallel resonance the impedance increases and the admittance decreases and current also decreases.